Hello students, how are you all? I hope everyone is fine and doing good in health. And also you all are regularly watching your online classes. Here in the subject, we are on chapter 4th, agriculture. And our current topic is the types of farming, which are of three types: the subsistence farming, commercial farming and organic farming. The subsistence farming and commercial farming we already studied. Now the organic farming is left. So our today's topic is organic farming. Before we come to know what is organic farming, let's first come to know what organic means. Organic means the specially for the food and farming method. The organic word here is used for the food or the farming method. It produced or using the natural materials without the artificial chemicals. The crops are grown by using the natural materials instead of the chemical fertilizers or the artificial chemicals. So first you see what is the definition. Organic farming. Now, organic farming is a method of crop and livestock production. It is a method of crop and livestock production that involves much more than choosing do not use pesticides, fertilizers, genetically modified organism, antibiotics and growth hormones. There is no use of the or artificial chemicals. The main aim of the organic farming is to avoid the use of the artificial chemicals, fertilizers, insecticides, pesticides. And in place of that, there is a use of organic waste. There is a use of organic waste or the natural waste, which are naturally produced. The waste which are naturally produced, natural waste. From where they get it? It is from the farm waste material, the crop waste, the waste that come out from the crops, then the animal waste. Animals are also producing or providing the dung. Cow dung is there, which is used as a manure. And sometimes in a small scale, the household waste. Household waste does not mean that what comes out, the waste material from the home. It is especially from the kitchen item. Leftover, the leaves of the vegetables after peeling off from the fruits, etc. The waste of the cooked food. So that waste is used to produce the manure. So the main aim of the chemical organic farming is to grow the crops by using the organic waste. This type of agricultural system which is originated in early 20th century in reaction to the rapid changing farming practices, as it seems that day by day the farmers are using the high yielding variety of seeds the natural artificial chemicals, fertilizers, insecticides, pesticides, which are very harmful for the health. So to avoid to consume such crops which are producing by using the artificial fertilizers, there is an origin of organic farming where the organic waste are used to grow the crops which are healthier for the human beings. So in order to check the health from the health point of view, the organic farming is introduced. Let's see what are the advantages of organic farming. First one is farmers can reduce their production cost. As in this farming, organic farming, farmers are going to use the organic waste instead of the chemical fertilizers or the artificial chemicals for which they have to pay very high cost. Here the organic waste which they use as a fertilizers or a manure, they have to pay very less or free of cost here. So their cost of production become less. Next is healthier farm workers. It is healthier for the farm workers also, as while spreading or sprinkling the chemical fertilizers on the crops, it is harmful to them when they smell or inhale that chemicals. But here, as no chemical is used in organic farming, so it become healthier for the workers who work on the farm. Next, in long term, it saves energy and protects the environment. Again, when what the chemical fertilizer is used on the crops, it just mix in the surrounding area, in the air. So again, it is harmful for the workers or the people living nearby. And at the time of rain, the excess water which flows down from the agricultural land and joined to the nearby pond, lake, river, canal. So that water is used by the animals and the human beings also for their household purpose, as well as the aquatic animals which are living in it. It is harmful for them that the artificial chemicals which are used in the crops. So by that, it is thus here in the organic farming, no chemical is used, so it protects the environment. It can slow down the global warming. How it slows down the global warming? As when there is less use of chemical fertilizers, less industries should be there. Fertilizers are prepared in the industries, in the factories. So when there is more organic farming, less the other use of fertilizer, chemical fertilizers, so less industries are there. As the industries, while preparing the products, they release the poisonous gas through their chimneys as well as the poisonous water from the in the form of waste material. So again, there is less global warming, as they are going to produce less gases through their chimneys, and which is one of the poisonous gas when mixed into the atmosphere, it leads to the global warming. Next is the fewer residues in food. There is a less possibility to get the dirt and the bacteria in the food. as the organic manure or the organic waste is used in the production, so there will be less possibility to get the any type of bacteria or the dirt in the food. So some of the advantages are there in the organic. Now, what are the characteristics of organic farming? Here, first is maximum but sustainable use of resources. The resources which are used are in maximum or are in large amount, but they are sustainable. They are not going to harm to the environment. Second, minimum use of purchased imports only as complementary to local resources. The things which are required to grow the crops in the organic farming are just very less things are to be purchased. Maximum things which are required are arranged from the local resources. Ensuring the basic biological functions of soil, water, nutrients, human continent. Here it ensures to maintain the nitrogen fixation by the use of legumes. Nitrogen fixation is the process that the nitrogen that is present in the atmosphere is absorbed by the roots of the plant, where it mixes with the soil and then it helps in the growth of the plants. So it maintains by growing the legumes. Legumes are the plants which have the seeds in a large pod, such as all the types of plants which have seeds in it. The beans are there, peas are there, peanuts are there. So those are called as the legumes. And as well as by recycling the organic materials which are left in the either by the waste material of the agricultural land or the crop waste, crop residues and the animals manure. So recycling of the plant residues as well as the animals manure. Then maintaining the diversity of plant and animal species as a basic for ecological balance and economic stability. It also maintains the biodiversity, as biodiversity boosts the ecosystem productivity. No matter how of all the species, no matter how small it is, they have equal importance and equal important role. So it also maintains the ecological balance and the economic stability. Here we have completed the topic types of farming. Have a good day. Thank you.